Hello everyone, welcome to System Software and Compilers Module 3 lecture video. In this lecture, let us solve some exercise problems on eliminating a left recursion from grammars and left factoring of grammars. Consider the example grammar T derives T star F or T slash F or F. So this is the given grammar, and the formula for eliminating a left recursion, if the production is of the form A derives A alpha 1 or A alpha 2 or beta, then A derives beta A dash and A dash derives alpha 1 A dash, alpha 2 A dash or epsilon. So by substituting the values, this T becomes A, star F is alpha 1, T is A, slash F is alpha 2 and F is beta. So now substitute the alpha 1, A and beta values in the non-left recursive productions. So T derives beta is F and T dash, so beta A dash is nothing but T dash. So T dash derives alpha 1 is star F A dash, that is T dash, or slash F T dash or beta, that is the epsilon. Consider the next example. S derives A or B. A derives A C or S D or epsilon. So here we have got the indirect left recursion. Then we need to eliminate the indirect left recursion by the method of substitution. So we need to substitute for S. So the grammar becomes S derives A or B. A derives A C or AAD or BD or epsilon. Now, in the first production, there is no left recursion, and in the second production, we have the left recursion. So, we need to apply the formula for the second production, that is A derives AC or AAD or BD or epsilon. So now we can write the formula for this one. So the production is A derives A alpha 1 or A alpha 2 or beta 1 or beta 2. Now the non-left recursive productions for these productions can be A derives beta 1 A dash or beta 2 A dash. A dash derives alpha 1 A dash or alpha 2 a dash or epsilon. So now we need to use these two non-left recursive productions and substitute the values for beta 1, beta 2, alpha 1 and alpha 2 and a dash. So here a is a, then c is alpha 1 and ad is alpha 2, bd is beta 1 and beta 2. So now by substitution we can write a derives beta 1 is bd, beta 1 is bd a dash, beta 2 is epsilon, then we can write a dash, and a dash derives alpha 1 a dash. Alpha 1 is c a dash, or alpha 2 is ad a dash or epsilon. These are the two non-left recursive productions of the second production, but the first production is S derives AA and B. This is the grammar which doesn't contain the left recursion. Now let us consider the third example. The grammar is S derives S, parenthesized S and one more S or epsilon. So now this is the given grammar. We need to eliminate a left recursion from this grammar. So we can write the formula as A derives A alpha 1 or beta. So this is the production format which contains the left recursion. Now the non-left recursive productions for the production is A derives beta A dash, A dash derives alpha 1 a dash or epsilon. So now in this example, S is A, so this is A and the rest is alpha 1 and epsilon is beta. So now substitute the values of A, alpha 1 and beta. So the non-left recursive grammar becomes S derives, beta is epsilon, so S derives S dash derives alpha 1 is parenthesized S followed by S and S dash or epsilon. So this is the grammar which doesn't contain the left recursion. Consider the next example grammar. S derives SS plus or SS star or A. So the formula will be A derives A alpha 1 or A alpha 2 or beta. Now the non-left recursive productions, after eliminating the left recursions, the productions will be A derives beta a dash, a dash derives alpha 1 a dash or alpha 2 a dash or epsilon. So substituting the values of beta a dash and alpha 1 alpha 2, the non-left recursive grammar becomes a s plus is alpha 1, s is a, alpha 2, and this is beta. So now s derives beta s dash derives alpha 1 is ss plus alpha 1 is s plus, so s plus s dash, or alpha 2 is s star s dash or epsilon. So this is the grammar after the left recursion. Consider another example grammar. S derives L or A. L derives L comma S or S. So in this grammar, the first production doesn't contain a left recursion, but the second production contains the left recursion. Hence, we need to eliminate the left recursion from the second production. So the formula can be written as A derives A alpha or beta. So the non-left recursive productions will be A derives beta A dash, A dash derives alpha A dash or epsilon. Hence, for the second production, the non-left recursive productions become L derives beta is S, so beta A dash derives alpha is comma S, followed by A dash is L dash or epsilon. The first production is written as it is. S derives L or A. So this is the grammar which doesn't contain a left recursion. Consider another example. B expression derives B expression or B term or B term. B term derives B term and B term. B factor or B factor. B factor derives not B factor or parenthesized B factor. B expression B expression or true or false. So in this grammar, the first production contains a left recursion and the second production contains a left recursion. we need to eliminate the left recursion from these two productions, and a third production doesn't contain a left recursion. So here B expression is A, B expression is A, or B term is alpha, and B term is beta. So after the removing the left recursion, the productions from the first productions will be B expression derives B term, B expression dash, B expression dash derives alpha. What is alpha? Or B term followed by B expression dash or epsilon. In the same way, if we consider the second production, B term becomes A, B term is A, and B factor becomes alpha, and B factor becomes beta. So the non-left recursive productions are B term derives, B factor, that is a beta, and then B term dash. So B term dash derives, or B term this must be B factor. Alpha is a B factor, so or B factor and B term dash or epsilon. The third production doesn't contain any left recursion, so that is written as it is. So B factor derives not B factor or B parenthesized B expression or true or false. So this is the grammar after eliminating the left recursion. Let us consider another problem, exercise problem, to eliminate the left recursion from the grammar. The grammar is S derives A or B, A derives A or epsilon, B derives B or SC or epsilon. First, here we need to remove the non-immediate left recursion. So it should be noted that the labeling of non-terminals is arbitrary. That means we can rearrange the production before labeling. This is much easier if we swap the second and third productions. So we can write it as S derives A or B, then B derives B or, now we need to substitute for S. So SC can be replaced by एसी और बीसी एंड देन एप्सिलॉन. After that, the next production is A derives A or epsilon. Now, remove the immediate left recursion from the second production. So, the non-left recursive productions for the second production are B derives AC, B dash, or B dash, and B dash derives, B dash, or CB dash, or epsilon. So these are the non-left recursive productions for the second production. Then now we remove the immediate left recursion from the third production. So the non-left recursive productions for the third production becomes A derives, A dash derives, A dash or epsilon. So, or epsilon. These two productions are same as A derives, A or epsilon. Putting all these together, the new grammar is S derives A or B, A or B, A derives A or epsilon, B derives A, C, B dash or B dash, B dash derives B, B dash or C, B dash or epsilon. Now let us consider the problems on left factoring of a grammar. So the first grammar is S derives IETS or IETSES or A. So now the formula can be used is A derives alpha beta 1 or alpha beta 2 or gamma. So now we can rewrite this one as A derives alpha beta or gamma, beta derives beta 1 or beta 2. So now we can apply this one for the grammar, and then we can rewrite that as S derives IETS followed by A or A derives beta 1 is epsilon and beta 2 is ES or epsilon. So, after the left factoring, these are the productions. Consider the next example. The example grammar is S derives यस प्लस और यस स्टार और ए. नाउ हियर यस इज अल्फा एंड प्लस इज बीटा वन, यस इज अल्फा एंड स्टार इज बीटा टू एंड ए इज गामा. सो वी कैन रीराइट दिस एज a derives, that is s derives alpha is s and to get a beta let us write b or a or gamma. So this b derives plus or star. So this is the grammar which is the left factored one. Consider the next example. The grammar is s derives 0 s 1 or 0 1. So here this is A and 0 is alpha, this is beta 1 and this 0 is alpha and this is beta 2. So we can rewrite this as S derives alpha B or a gamma, gamma is epsilon. So then this B derives S1, that is beta 1 or 1 beta 2. After the left factoring of the grammar, these are the productions. Let us consider another example. The grammar is S derives S plus S or S or parenthesized S or S star or A. Now here we need to find out the alpha, beta and gamma. So this is A and this is alpha, this is beta 1, this is alpha, this is beta 2, this is gamma 1, this is alpha and this is beta 3 and this is gamma 2. So now we can rewrite this as S derives alpha, alpha is S, for beta we can write it as a B, or gamma 1, gamma 2. Gamma 1 is parenthesized S or gamma 2 is A, and beta for B derives beta 1, this is plus S, or beta 2 is S, or beta 3 is star. So after left factoring the grammar, these are the productions. Consider the another example to left factor. The grammar is S derives T semicolon S or epsilon, T derives U dot T or U, and U derives X or Y or S. The second production must be left factored. So T derives U dot T or U. So here this is alpha and this is alpha, this is beta. So we can rewrite this one as t derives u r, r derives dot t or epsilon. So the resultant grammar after the left factoring, the grammar is s derives t semicolon s or epsilon, t derives u r, r derives dot t or epsilon, and u derives x or y or s.